Before we turn to finding a faster algorithm for finding a maximum matching, there's a classic theorem related to matchings that we should talk about. This is the Frobenius-Hall theorem.
For a subset of vertices, say x, we'll use n of x to indicate the union of the neighbors of the individual vertices in x. If we consider this graph here, then the neighbors of the orange vertices will be the green ones. Note that the fact that if we call this x, then the size of the neighborhood of x is larger than x, that this bodes well for the possibility of finding a matching for all the vertices on the left-hand side here. At least there's a chance that we'll be able to find a match for all these vertices. When this is not the case, however, as seen for these three vertices here, then it is hopeless. Regardless of how we match the first two, there will be no remaining candidates for the third vertex. We can make this intuition precise with the Frobenius-Hall theorem, which follows from the max-matching min-vertex-cover argument. Given a bipartite graph G, partitioned into L and R, there exists a matching of size L if and only if, for every x which is a subset of L, the size of the neighborhood of x is at least the size of x. The forward direction is the simpler one. We'll let M be a matching of size L, and we'll let x be a subset of the left-hand side. We let y be the vertices on the right-hand side that x got matched to. Well, then clearly y is the same size as x. But then y is also a subset of the neighborhood of x, and hence the size of the neighborhood of x is at least the size of x. The other direction is a little more challenging. Suppose not. We'll let M be a max matching with cardinality strictly less than the cardinality of the left-hand side. We let H be the set of vertices reachable from an alternating path from the unmatched vertices in L. This is the same picture used in the max-matching min-vertex cover argument. There's at least one unmatched vertex here by our assumption. Well, then the neighborhood of the left-hand side of H is equal to the right-hand side of H. But this left-hand side must be strictly greater because there's at least one unmatched vertex. If you like, you can think about the matched vertices on either side canceling each other out, and we're left with some non-zero number of unmatched vertices on the left-hand side.